Well, hello and welcome once again to Truro Cathedral for our next instalment of our Friday lunchtime organ recital series. It's wonderful to see so many of you here on this beautiful afternoon. It's worth reminding you that there will be no recital next Friday due to graduations happening here, but the series resumes the week after on the 29th of July with Charles Francis from Birmingham. It will soon become clear that today's recitalist is indeed not Stefan Donner, but is in fact our organ scholar Alden Wright. Alden has been with us since the start of September and has very quickly felt part of the furniture. His contributions to the music in the cathedral have been extraordinary, be it accompanying the cathedral choir, the St. Mary's singers, teaching the probationer choristers, looking after the library, or stepping in at short notice to fill a gap in the recital series. I'm very grateful to Alden for all his work, and I know that you have truly enjoyed hearing him on our wonderful Willis this year too. So please join me in giving Alden a warm welcome to come and speak about his recital today.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's great to see such a nice crowd here today, despite the amazing weather that's out just outside the door. It's a pleasure, if a bit bittersweet, to be here to present my last recital as organ scholar here. As I was thinking about what I might play, I've chosen a program which I hope you'll find interesting. I had some ideas in mind, and it's always nice when a program comes together as something sort of cohesive and thematic, and so I think this program really fell into place nicely. The first half will feature music by German music from the German musical tradition, showcasing some of the best pieces of the 18th century master Bach and the 19th century master Reger. Bach's Toccata in E is monumental, probably written in his youthful years, following the more free style of his mentor, Buxtehude. There are two separate but related fugues, interspersed between more virtuosic flourishes. To contrast, we'll hear two small chorale preludes, which are really sort of brilliant miniatures. The first, making genius use of writing in canon, which produces some really interesting harmonic possibilities. The second will ease into the chromatic world of Reger with a very chromatic and uniquely progressive setting of the chorale, Now the Old Year Passes. The next piece might sound a bit wild and exotic to our modern ears, especially next to Bach, but this Reger Toccata and Fugue is very much within 19th century German musical sensibilities, still with a very clear link to the earlier German masters. It's sort of a conveyance of raw emotion with quite a turbulent toccata and an exciting, uplifting fugue. The second half traces parallels within the French organ tradition with music by two organists of the same famous Parisian church, Sainte Clotilde. First, the more modern of the two, Bonnal, with two highly evocative pieces which utilize an impressionist musical language to convey images of the landscape of the Pyrenees Mountains in the Basque country between Spain and southern France. The first is a depiction of a valley deep within the mountains, perhaps exploring the interplay between light and darkness in the early morning hours. The second is the languid tune of a lonely shepherd making his way through the mountains and the surrounding sort of stark landscape. We'll then finish with the very transcendent chorale in E by Franck. This piece is given particular meaning because it was written as one of the last pieces he ever composed, as if to pour sort of his entire emotional output into it and the two that follow. This one, I think, I always hear it as being full of promise and gentle assurance after moments of uncertainty. It sounds youthful, I think, and I think that's perhaps a reflection of the composer's own youth. So it brings the program back full circle to the key of E major, matching the equal positivity of the Toccata in E by Bach. Musically, I think it's a masterpiece, the way the themes are developed, which really take the listener on a journey, leading to one of the most exciting climaxes in the repertoire, I think. But emotionally, it's almost unmatched in its depth and profundity. So I look forward to presenting these amazing pieces to you today, and I hope that you enjoy listening to them, and I hope that you enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you.